What's up, barbecue lovers? Hope you're having a beautiful summer already. It's still a little bit overcast. Beautiful day to fire up the Hastings, especially since we're doing a review on the Hastings today. As many of you know, I am the Hasty-Bake ambassador, and if you saw my first video on the Hasty-Bake Legacy stainless steel model, you know I only had one little minor complaint about it, that it wasn't quite big enough for me to cook more than a couple of meats at a time in competition. So Hasty-Bake heard me loud and clear, and a Hastings charcoal grill came into my possession. Well, I'm planning to use it in my backyard, but I'm also looking to build a competition cart for it and take it on the competition trail. Now, this review is gonna be a little bit different than my legacy review. As if you saw the legacy review, we were able to unbox it, unwrap it, assemble it, and put it all together, build a fire in it, and actually cook on it all on the same day. This one, I just couldn't wait, and I needed to cook a whole hog. So I went ahead and fired it up a couple of weeks ago after I got it, and we actually cooked a whole hog on it. It cooked amazing, held temperature, held even temperature on both sides of the grill with very little fuel, very efficient, and did an awesome job. I had not cooked a whole hog in probably 15 or 16 years, so I was a little timid about cooking it on a brand new grill that I had never used before, but I did fire it up the night before with a little bit of charcoal on both of the fire baskets just to kind of get an idea of where the heat was gonna go. I figured out it was gonna run a little bit hot. One of the things about stainless steel grills, when they're new, before they get seasoning on the inside and stuff, they're gonna run really hot because they have reflective heat. So I kind of figured that out right away the previous evening. So I ran with a little bit less charcoal, and lo and behold, it actually ran very efficiently, and I was able to cook the whole hog in about 5 hours with very little charcoal in each of my fire baskets. I was able to maintain about 250, 275, occasionally 300 degrees in temperature. I would just choke it down a little bit, and I added a little bit of lump charcoal as I went throughout the cook, and it just cooked an amazing pig. It was beautiful, tasted wonderful, and everybody loved it. So with that said, let's roll that beautiful cooking B-roll. So there's 8 things that you really want to think about when you're looking at purchasing a Hastings model. Let's get into the firebox. It has one big firebox that's a common firebox for a dual zone fire trays. It has 2 fire trays in there. They're both adjustable, but it's one common firebox, so you can run on one side or the other. The next thing to think about is the storage area. It has a nice, big, roomy storage area underneath, and even when you're running fire inside the firebox, it's nice in there. It doesn't get hot, so nothing's gonna burn in there. Now, Hasty-Bake has a great door system on all their models. The Hastings is no exception. You have a left knob to open and close the door, and you have a right knob to open and close the door. It's very simple, very efficient, very functional. Now, for the cooking section of it, the Hastings is one entire rack larger than the legacy models. The legacies come with 2 grates internally to cook on. The Hastings has 1 more. It's 3, so it's longer. And it also has a second rack that's just as long, equally long, that you can also cook extra meats on as well. Okay, so speaking of the firebox, one of the cool things about the Hastings, it comes with dual fire trays. They both have their own individual crank that you can raise or lower your heat source. If you're running a little bit behind or you're almost done cooking and you don't want to add any more charcoal, just turn that crank clockwise. You'll get that fire up a little bit closer to your meat, get a little bit hotter, and finish the job. Another cool thing about that is it makes it an amazing dual zone cooker. You can have fire on one side and your meat way over here on the other side if you want to cook low and slow. For example, a brisket or a pork butt or something that takes a little bit more time. You don't always want that heat source like really close to your meat. So another cool thing is that each fire tray comes with its own individual deflector. So if you don't want any direct heat, you can just set that deflector right on top of the fire tray. And you can even put a water pan on top of that. If you're the kind that wants a little more moisture in your food and your barbecue, put that little water pan in there. The heat will simmer that water and it'll make your meat even juicier and more moist. Also, each firebox comes with its own individual removable ash pan. So if you only cooked on one side today, guess what? You don't have to take the whole thing out, one big giant pan. You actually have two individual pans, so you only need to clean the one that you used. I highly, highly recommend you use foil on the bottom of it so that you can empty out your ashes when you're done cooking, just like on the legacy models. Roll that foil up with the ash in it, throw it in the trash, boom, you're done. Simple, efficient, and clean. And one of the neatest things, one of my favorite things about it is that it comes with little casters. So if you have a patio or a backyard with concrete, it's really easy to maneuver and roll around. It has brakes on the wheels so that you can push the brakes on them. It won't be moving around while you're trying to open and close the lid and get meat in out of your grill. The coolest thing about the casters is that it helps the Hastings be one of the most versatile backyard grill because it's very mobile in addition to being an awesome cooker. It can sit in your backyard kitchen, that stainless steel looking beautiful. Or you can wheel it onto the back of a trailer or roll it into the back of your truck and take it to a tailgating party. Now, one of the last things to think about with the Hastings is the thermometers. The Hastings comes with two thermometers, one for each side or each zone of the grill. That really makes it nice because if you have a fire on one side, you'll be able to have a reading on the temperature, but if you want to run a lower temperature on the other side, you'll be able to tell what temperature you're cooking at as well. So a few more thoughts on the Hastings model. One funny thing I noticed is that it's a little bit tall for a short guy like me, but the average person is not a little short guy like me, so it's probably gonna be perfect for you. And the last two things that I think are really, really cool about the Hastings, as we mentioned before already, the exhaust system, I just think it's super cool. It's neat because you have an exhaust on either side, so regardless of which way the wind's blowing, it does have a somewhat of a convection system because by design, and so it will cook nice and even regardless of where you put the fire. But it's kind of nice to know that when you want to use your dual zone functionality, you can put the fire on whichever side you want and the exhaust on the other. That makes it really, again, very, very versatile. And lastly, I want to touch very briefly on the grease drip system. Like the Hastings has a little different design where the grease catch box actually is inside the grill. So you're never going to drip anything outside into your pretty outdoor kitchen or your pretty patio. It's all going to stay right there in that little box. Now, at the end of the day, the Hastings was originally designed, as I mentioned, to be built into an outdoor kitchen, and with the casters makes it a little bit more versatile for the average backyard with a patio. Not everybody's going to want to take it to a competition. Not everybody's a comp guy like me, but it's good to know that if you wanted to, you could. I would highly recommend that you cook on it a few times to kind of get a feel for it and get to know the dual zone temperatures and how much fire to use before you actually take it out on the cooking trail. And that pretty much wraps it up for the Hastings grill. I highly, highly recommend it. It's an awesome cooker with, again, a lot of versatility for the backyard or your outdoor kitchen. Highly, highly recommend it. If you want something beautiful that cooks efficiently and that is very functional and that you can have a lot of control over your fire and with a lot of capacity as well, the Hastings is the grill for you. Thanks for watching, everybody. If you like this video, remember to like, comment, and share, and subscribe. Go ahead and leave us a comment and let me know what you think about this video and about the Hastings. I still got a little bit of fire out there, so I'm gonna go out there and cook some ribs for dinner tonight. Remember to keep the smoke light. Make it work.